So we're gonna watch David Wilkerson, Last Day's Deception, through screen share.
He I want to remind you that he never does anything. He was the pastor who reached Nikki Cruz, and then through Nikki Cruz, Pastor Sonny was reached by this David Wilkerson. Yeah. Okay, we're ready to listen the speech.
Things that he warns. The gospel of accommodation. Now, to accommodate means to adapt. It means to make suitable or acceptable. It also means to adjust, to make something very convenient. It means to yield to the desires of others, to placate them. Now, you put that together, and I'm talking about a gospel that's been invented in hell and is now being propagated all over the United States. It's a suitable, acceptable, convenient, a gospel that has yielded to the desires and the weakness of sinful men. I call it the gospel of accommodation because it's adapting and adjusting the gospel to appease and attract sinners. This gospel accommodation is primarily an American cultural invention to ease our lifestyle. It appeals primarily to white America, rich and prosperous. It was invented out of hell itself. This new gospel is sweeping the America and the nation. It's influencing ministers of every denomination. It's giving birth to mega churches. Some of the largest churches in the United States are involved in this gospel. It's a non-confronting, convenient gospel adapted. It is spoon-fed to the congregation by skits, humorous skits and drama, short, non-abrasive, 20-minute messages, and it's all called seeker-friendly. The seeker-friendly churches. And one of these days, there may be somebody move into the city and try to bring one of these churches right into New York City. They are springing up now overnight, and suddenly thousands attend. This new gospel is being propagated by...
All right. Hi, Jannetty. So what we're doing now is that we're watching David Wilkerson's message.
David Wilkerson was the pastor who reached Nikki Cruz, and then Nikki Cruz reached Pastor Sonny Argisoni. But why I choose the pastor to hear today, David Wilkerson, because it's necessary that the speech that he did in 1958 is explained the future the church is living now.
Yeah, so he's talking about churches that are seeker friendly, which they're predominantly accepted in white rich America, which it doesn't really confront you. It's more like comforting, which is not a bad thing, but it's only a bad thing because the word of God, it's supposed to comfort you and also convict you to be better. And
sí, déjame explicarte un poquito en español. La estamos escuchando esta charla a los días de decepción de David Wilkerson. David Wilkerson fue uno de los pastores que alcanzó a Nikki Cruz, y a través de Nikki Cruz fue alcanzado Pastor Argisoni, Sonny Argisoni, por el cual pues nosotros somos Victory Outreach. Fue el primer pastor que tuvo ese ministerio en las calles. Okay, vamos a continuar.
Bright, young, intelligent, talented ministers. They came upon a formula by which you can go into any city in any town and almost overnight build a mega church. And as I understand this formula, you begin by going into the community with your workers and you poll the community to find out what the sinner found offensive about attending church. Well, why don't you attend church? And what was offensive about it? And what would we have to do to bring you back into the church? What would make you comfortable? What would you like to see? You don't like choirs, we'll do away with choirs. You don't like suits in church, you come the way you choose. Just tell us what you want. And they survey the community and then sit in there with their computers and in their conference rooms, and they design a program that will make it comfortable for the sinner and make it friendly for, they rather than call it sinner friendly, they would call it seeker friendly, and try to attract them to come into the house of God. It's becoming the most prosperous, most flourishing of all religious movements in the history of America. The churches are run like corporations. The pastor's the CEO, chief executive officer. And it's big business. And this formula has now been cleverly packaged, and it is now being pushed in seminars all over the United States. It sounds good. What they say sounds very good. It sounds spiritual in its goals. It sounds like Jesus is the central theme. And folks, I'm not going to name any names because I'm not talking about the character of these men. I'm talking about the gospel that they preach. I am here to remind you that Paul the Apostle warned of the coming of another gospel, which we have not preached. He said there is coming another gospel that's going to preach another Jesus. You'll hear his name. It'll sound sweet, but it's not the Jesus that I preach, Paul said. It's not the true Jesus. Paul goes on, or Paul was amazed. He said that you are so removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ to another gospel. Folks, listen to me. There is in the land right now, with thousands of people sitting under it, another gospel, another Jesus, being preached by ministers who have lost the touch of God and been transformed into angels of light, the common to deceive, if possible, even the elect of God. Paul goes to warn the church. It's really not another gospel, but it's a perversion of the gospel of Christ, which is really not another, Paul said, but there be some that trouble you and pervert or change the gospel of Christ. He said they're going to change it. They're going to accommodate the sinner. They're going to accommodate their pleasures. They're going to accommodate all of their needs, and they're going to design a gospel with their own Christ, with their own doctrine. Then this awful warning from Paul. But though we, or an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you but that which we preached unto you, let him be accursed. Let him be accursed. Folks, I didn't say that. The Apostle Paul said it. If anybody preach another gospel, what you've heard, if anyone preach anything but the crucified Christ, if anyone preach anything that appeases man in his sin, that's not the gospel you heard from me, Paul said, and anyone preaches another, let him be accursed. And he said it's going to be dangerous because it's going to come from seemingly pious, sincere ministers. That's what made the doctrine called antinomianism so dangerous, because it was in the hands of some very fine, good-living men like Dr. Crisp, who was one of the founders of that anti-law movement back during the Puritan age. Anti-law, they cast aside the burden of the law. And the reason it was so accepted, because the men who preached it seemed to be so pious. And I tremble when I hear Paul warn us that Satan's going to come right into the church, disguised as an angel of light. He's going to infiltrate into the church with his own ministers. They'll come angel-like, he said, preaching a false gospel of righteousness. For such are false prophets, false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it's no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose ends will be according to their works. Paul said they're going to come and they're going to glory in the flesh. They're going to glory in their might, their money. They're going to glory in their bigness, their numbers, and they're going to glory in the fact that they are so contemporary. They're going to glory in their acceptance by the world. Jesus warned, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing. They're to come like gentle sheep, sincere, intelligent, bright, but said inward they're ravening wolves. And folks, Jesus gave that in the context of his message. He said, because straight is the gate, narrow is the way which leadeth to life, and few there be that find it. And the very next verse, he says, beware of false prophets. You're going to come in sheep's clothing, but they're ravening wolves. It's Christ himself warning us. False prophets, false pastors, false evangelists, posing as submissive sheep, going to come saying the way is not that narrow. The way is not that straight. And they're going to accommodate. They're going to change the gospel to suit the needs of the people. Jesus puts his finger on the motives behind them. Ambition.
Yeah.
The word ravening here. Raven.
If we hear, si nosotros escuchamos, esa es la parte más importante de una predicación de un pastor con mucha experiencia refiriéndose hacia el futuro, lo que es la acomodación de la palabra de acuerdo a sus deseos, ¿ves? Así que nosotros como niños pues tenemos que también estar actualizados y saber pues qué es lo que estamos predicando, qué es lo que estamos escuchando, cómo nos estamos alimentando espiritualmente. Porque tenemos que tener cuidado con las falsas doctrinas, falsos profetas, falsos evangelistas, predicadores que están predicando en la carne y que actúan bajo la carne. Cuando hablamos de la carne, estamos hablando del comportamiento humano al correr del mundo. O sea, ¿qué es lo que un cristiano hace y qué es lo que un cristiano no debe de hacer? Entonces tenemos dos mundos, ¿verdad? El mundo de las creencias que nos enseñaron nuestros padres en el pasado. Muchos niños vienen de padres que antes tenían una X religión, que tenían X creencia o X comportamiento, ¿verdad? Entonces, cuando hablamos del mundo es personas que no asisten a una iglesia regularmente, niños que no van a iglesia correctamente, que no van a una iglesia regularmente, que no tienen doctrina a través de la palabra, que tienen la fe que sus padres les enseñan, ¿verdad? O sea, el conocimiento que sus padres les enseñan. Entonces, ¿por qué es importante como niños conocer las olas que mueven a la comunidad o a la vida cristiana alrededor del mundo? Porque para no caer en las tendencias de estar con falsas profecías, ¿entiende?
Mm-hmm. I'd like to add something.
Sí.
That when David Wilkerson was saying that some churches are becoming comfortable to fit the needs of the people, that is not the way that it's supposed to be. The word is supposed to be convicting, and it's not supposed to be comfortable for you. Because, as you know, as what Mama said, narrow is the path for heaven. It is not comfortable, and it is not enjoyable at times, because you feel convicted, and it is difficult. It's not easy. That's why you should be aware if churches are only preaching of things that sound nice and make you feel nice all the time, that is not Jesus. Jesus is supposed to, the Bible is supposed to teach you, convict you, and make you feel, wow, that's what I need to do.
Yeah. The other point is, el otro punto es que toma es este programas diseñados. O sea, en la parte de la programación mental, es como que agarremos un recording y nosotros empecemos a grabar lo que nosotros queremos. Eso es como un brainwash, como que te estén lavando el cerebro. Entonces, programas diseñados, acomodados a lo que ellos quieren, lo que ellos piensan.
I just remembered a verse that said, the child that God loves, he disciplines.
Exacto. Entonces, es la disciplina. ¿Dónde vamos a aprender toda esta disciplina? Es en la palabra. Es la única manera. Todo lo que nosotros digamos en nuestra carne, en nuestra opinión, son palabras nada más. Pero los hechos están en tener esta palabra y llevar esta palabra. Es lo que el mensaje prácticamente de William Wilkerson nos quiere decir. ¿verdad? Porque muchos vendrán como ángeles de luz. Entonces, esta mañana, pues yo quise compartir esto para llevarles a la reflexión, ¿por qué somos Victoria Rich? ¿De dónde nace Nicky Cruz? ¿De dónde nace Pastor Sonny? ¿Verdad? La fundación. Y el por qué, pues, tenemos esta misión de que amamos, ¿verdad? Al caído, al que esté en las calles y pues, parte de la visión, ¿no es? Entonces, pero sin olvidar de mantenernos siempre enfocados en la palabra, literalmente. Fuera de la palabra de Dios, sí.
Yo tengo una idea de qué podemos hacer para estar interactuando. Porque lo que yo tengo es un Bible study.
Sí.
Y básicamente lo que hace es that you read some chapters and then you have questions to answer them.
Estrella está hablando ahorita de lo que es el programa interactivo. ¿Cómo funciona en la internet un programa interactivo para niños, verdad?
What we could do every day is assign like a chapter.
Sí.
And then I put the questions here.
Bueno, vamos a estar desarrollando ese programa interactivo. Tratamos de buscar las técnicas que más aplican, ¿verdad? Para el desarrollo de los niños. Pero en este día solamente quería llevarles esa reflexión y luego estaremos hablando de las nuevas modificaciones que vamos a hacer en cuanto al programa interactivo vía Zoom y que se puedan conectar la mayor cantidad de niños que se puedan conectar y que la palabra, pues, sobre todo, tenga frutos en ustedes. Vamos a dar gracias a Dios para cerrar con este meeting y gracias a los que se conectaron y los que se van a seguir conectando. Padre de la gloria, Señor, te damos gracias una vez más, un día más, por todo lo que has hecho, por todo lo que harás, por todo lo que eres y por el tiempo que nos das para compartir la palabra. Bendice, Señor, a los que se conectaron a este día y bendice a los que no se conectaron también, Señor. Y que sea la palabra que nos guíe en estos tiempos de acomodación, Señor, y de ajustes de la palabra al mundo. Gracias te damos, Señor, por los hombres y mujeres que han hecho historia, buena historia en el pasado, para llevar un evangelio, Señor, edificante. En el nombre de Jesús te damos gracias. Amén y amén.
Yeah, and I want to say thank you, Jenny, for joining us today.
Jenny.
Oh, Jenny. Yes, Jenny. Sí. I said Jenny the whole time.
Sí.
But yeah, it's not the most difficult. It's not the easiest thing to do. It's not the funnest thing you could do. Like, based on what other people think, it's fun. But what you do will not go in vain. Oh, habla inglés.
Español, más español.
Oh, español. Okay, lo siento. Quiero decir gracias por reunirse hoy. Lo que haces es muy bien porque tú sabes, hay muchas personas que prefieren hacer otra cosa, pero tu amor y pasión para aprender la palabra de Dios es muy critical y muy importante en estos días. Entonces, gracias por estar aquí y gracias por escuchar hoy.
Bye, Jenny. Muchas gracias, sí, y esperamos verte el próximo sábado a las 10 de la mañana.